Gas laws here. A couple of things that you should be able to use. The ideal gas equation gives you PV equals nRT. An ideal gas is a slightly peculiar construction. There is no such thing in practice as an ideal gas, but a lot of gases behave very close to an ideal gas. In an ideal gas, you have monatomic atoms, which don't actually have any volume. The closest we can get is helium, although dry nitrogen is pretty good. Dry nitrogen at reasonable sorts of temperatures behaves very, very close to an ideal gas. And this equation you have at the top, PV equals nRT. P is pressure, V is volume, nRT, N is the number of moles of gas that you have, R is the molar gas constant, and T is the temperature. It's important to measure the temperature in Kelvin. If you measure the temperature in centigrade or Fahrenheit or any other bizarre unit, it's going to go wrong. The point about Kelvin temperatures is that they can only be positive. Absolute zero, which is the lowest temperature you can get when there's no energy left, is minus 273 degrees centigrade. 0 degrees centigrade is 273 Kelvin. So if you're multiplying anything by temperature, it's got to be in Kelvin. Otherwise you could end up with 0 degrees centigrade, multiply it by something, and all of your answers turn into zero, which is inconvenient. The point about this equation at the bottom is that for a sample of gas, provided that you're not actually adding any gas to it or taking any away, PV over T is a constant. So pressure times volume divided by temperature gives you a constant. If you then vary the pressure, volume, and temperature, so you've got a sample of gas and you press a plunger into your bicycle pump, whatever it is, the pressure, the volume, and the temperature can all change, but if you carry out this procedure on them, pressure times the volume divided by temperature, with the new values, you'll get the same answer. It'll give you a constant. And what that means is that if you vary two of those but you leave the third one constant, you don't need to know what the third one is, because it cancels. If T1 equals T2, you don't need to know what it is. It cancels out.